Who the hell are you?
Nick Fury, director of S.H.I.E.L.D.
Huh.
I'm here to talk to you about the Avenger Initiative.
Holy shit! If you told me a decade ago that Marvel Comics would ever start their own film studio specifically to make superhero movies in a connected universe and cross the characters over into each other's movies, culminating in a full-on Avengers movie, I'd have called you an optimistic fool. But that's exactly what that stinger at the end of Iron Man meant. That's exactly where they seem to be heading. So the Escapist and I thought it'd be fun to look back at the clues and crossovers so far and take some guesses at where we're going with this. But first, let's go to the beginning. The Avengers are basically Marvel's version of the Justice League. Damn near everyone in the Marvel Universe has been on the team at one point or another, but the core three are usually listed as Captain America, Iron Man, and Thor. It's the Kirk, Spock, McCoy, id, ego, superego thing. Or, looking at it another way, one representative each of the three main types of superheroes. Costumed human hero, technology hero, and magical hero. The movies, so far, are on the same kick. Iron Man 2 is set to be followed by a Thor movie, then a Captain America movie, and then everyone teams up for the Avengers movie, including maybe even the Hulk. So how's that gonna work? How is a high-tech espionage franchise, a sci-fi monster mash, a mythological fantasy, and a World War II pulp adventure gonna mix into one thing? Well, here's what we know so far. In the first Iron Man movie, we saw the rise of a top-secret government intelligence outfit called S.H.I.E.L.D., whose director Nick Fury shows up at the end to tell Iron Man about the Avengers Initiative. Then Iron Man showed up at the end of The Incredible Hulk to tell General Ross about forming a team.
What if I told you we were putting a team together?
Also from the Hulk, remember that General Ross told Emil Blonsky that the super soldier serum they used to give him powers and ultimately turn him into the Abomination came from World War II? Well, if you looked really quick at the name on the chemical canister, that was Dr. Reinstein's. In the comics, Reinstein was the scientist who created Captain America, meaning that this stuff is probably the same stuff, you get the idea. Oh, one more. In a scene that was deleted from the Hulk movie but included on the special edition DVD, Hulk caused an avalanche in Antarctica. According to the director, Louis Leterrier, that shape right there in the ice is the frozen body of Captain America. Why is he frozen? Okay, quick version. Deep breath.
Captain America was Marvel's big hero during World War II. He was a sickly kid named Steve Rogers who got treated with the super soldier serum and became a patriotic superhero. He fought the Nazis and the Red Skull. In the 50s, they had him fighting communists, which was lame, so they canceled it. Then in the 60s, they retconned a new story that said that guy from the 50s was actually an imposter, and the real Captain America has been frozen in suspended animation since the end of the war. In Avengers number 4, he was thawed out and joined the team, an old-fashioned John Wayne-type patriotic hero struggling to find his place in the social upheaval of the 1960s.
And exhale. And that's what we know so far. Marvel isn't letting anyone see anything from Thor or Captain America yet, though we do know that Thor will take place on Earth and Asgard, and that Captain America will be an origin story set in World War II and co-starring the international superhero team, the Invaders. Chris Hemsworth is playing Thor for director Kenneth Branagh. Chris Evans is playing Cap for Joe Johnston. Maybe one or both of them will show up as the surprise in Iron Man 2? We'll know about that in a month, but until then, here's what we can tell from Iron Man 2's trailer. James Rhodes becomes War Machine, aka Iron Man plus guns. He's been an Avenger in the comics, will he be one in the movies? Scarlett Johansson is playing Natasha Romanoff, aka the Black Widow. Will she be an Avenger? I don't know, but I do know that squeezing Scarlett Johansson into a black vinyl body stocking is such a good idea, I don't care what team she's on. That said, when it comes to Marvel, if you see Black Widow, fellow Avenger Hawkeye, aka Purple Man with bow and arrow, is usually close behind. Oh, and just in case, if a guy named Donald Blake shows up wandering around the Iron Man movie for no reason, he's probably Thor. The credits list Mad Men's John Slattery as playing Tony Stark's father, Howard Stark, who's dead, so that'd have to be in flashbacks. And you know, Tony Stark seems to be in his mid to late 40s, right? So depending on how old Howard Stark was when he had kids, he could conceivably have been alive in World War II. And since the Starks have apparently always made military technology, and Tony already knew all about the super soldier serum at the end of Hulk, do you think maybe Stark the Elder was somehow involved with you-know-who? I mean, that'd make sense to me. I'm not being cute about that, though, just to make that clear. I'm just guessing. I have no special information on any of this, but wouldn't that be cool? And you know, as fun as it is to speculate and geek out about all the details of this stuff, even just looking at the big picture, how much ass does this kick? I mean, even if you're not a big comic fan or don't care about all this continuity business, how cool is it that there's going to be a movie, nay, a movie universe, where all this different sort of stuff is all mixed up together? A resurrected World War II adventurer, a guy in a robot suit, and literally the Viking god of thunder, plus who knows what else, all hanging out and fighting side by side, science fiction, fantasy, action, all at once? I mean, how can you not look forward to that? See you next time.